Jai Hind, my dear students.
Today we are going to study the chapter 8, comparing quantities.
What can you say about this number? You will read it as 1 divided by 2 or 1 by 2. A few students also said is a fraction. So what is this exactly as a fraction? Fraction is a number that represent a part of the whole, like half of a one chocolate or half of an apple, right? Let me tell you one more interesting thing about that with an example. If you go to a picnic and two of your friends have to share one sandwich, then how much be one of the friends get? Half of the sandwich, right? This is the fraction. We can also say that one sandwich is shared between two people, that is 1 divided by 2 or 1 is to 2. And number in this form is known as a ratio. When we compare two things or find a quantitative relation between two quantities, we get a ratio. Five pencils divided into two friends, Jim and Tim, in the ratio 3:2 or 3:2. This means we will have to give 3 pencil to Jim and 2 pencil to Tim. Correct? Put this 3:2 is a fraction? No. Here the fraction of pencil to Jim is 3:5 and Tim is 2:5. That is, you have total 5 pencil and out of that 3 pencil you have given to Jim and out of 5 pencil, 2 pencil you have given to Tim. But in the ratio 3:2 or 3:2 means you have to give 3 pencil to Jim and 2 pencil to Tim. A ratio deals 2 or more quantities, whereas fraction deals 1 quantity.
Problems on ratios. First question, find the ratio of rupees 5 to 50 paise. Listen, when we comparing two quantities, the unit must be same. Here given the first quantity unit is in rupees, second quantity rupee unit is in paise. So first we want to change these two quantities are in same units. Okay, so we know 1 rupee is equal to 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. Okay, 1 rupee is equal to 100 paise. So we can change into this rupees into paise. Very simple, multiply by 100. So rupees multiply by 100 change into paise. Okay, rupees multiply by 100 change into paise. So here given the quantities rupees 5 is to 50 paise. Okay, change into this rupees into paise, multiply by 100. So 5 into 100 is to the change into paise. 5 into 100 paise is equal to 50 paise. Okay, then we can reduce this. 5 into 100 is, yes, 500 paise is to 50 paise. Okay, 500 paise is to 50 paise. We know every ratio we can write into, suppose A is to B, we can write as equal to A by B. Okay, so 500 paise is to 50 paise, we can write as 500 by 50. We can cancel this 0. 5 and 50, 10. Okay, so we get 10 paise. We can cancel this 50 and 50. Here 1, then this 0. 50 paise is to, this 50 change into, yes, 1 here. 1 paise. Okay, so the ratio is 10:1. That is the final reducible ratio. Okay, then 9 meter to 27 centimeter. Listen, here the first quantity is in meter and the second quantity is in centimeter. We know 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Okay, so meter change into centimeter multiplied by 100, that change into centimeter. So 9 meter change into, here 9 meter is to 27 centimeter. 9 meter change into centimeter multiply by 100, change into that becomes centimeter, then 27 centimeter. Now we get 9 into 100 is 900 centimeter is to 27 centimeter. So we can write that that is in 900 by ratio 900 is to 27, that is equal to 900 by 27. So we can cancel by 3. 9 threes are 27, here 3 threes are 900. Okay, again we can divide, cancel by 3. 3 threes are 9, this is 100. Okay, so we get this reducible form. 900 is in reducible to 100. 100 is to this 3. Okay, 100 is to 3 as the final reducible ratio. Okay, then 15 kilogram to 210 gram. So we know 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. Okay, so kilogram change into gram, we want to multiply by 1000. So 1 into 1000 gram, 1 kilogram into 1000 gram, we get 1000. 1 kilogram into 1000 equal to gram. Okay, kilogram into 1000 equal to gram. So this kilogram, 15 kilogram is to 210 gram. Kilogram change into gram multiply by 1000 is to 200 gram. This also gram. So we get 15,000 gram is to 210 gram. We can write as in fractional form 15,000 by 210. Can cancel this 0, 0. Then we can divide it by this as in 3. 7 threes are 21. This is 5 threes are 15, then put this 0, 500 by 7. So next is not possible to reduce into lowest term. So this lowest ratio of 15,000 is to 210 is 500 is to 7. Okay, numerator 500, denominator 7. So 500 is to 7. Then 30 days to 36 hours. Here, one quantity is in days and the second quantity is in hours. So, we know 1 day how many hours? 1 day equal to 24 hours. Okay. So, day change into hours multiply by day into 24. That change into hours. Okay. So, 30 days is to 36 hours. 30 days change into hours. 24 hours is to 36 hours. Then multiply, we get 24 into 30. Yes, 720. 3 fours are 12, 1 balance. Then 3 twos are 6 plus 1 7. Then put this 0. 720 hours is to 36 hours. So now we can write as in a fractional format. 720 divided by 36. We know 36 into 2 is 72. So this is in 2 times, 36 in 1 times. Okay. 36 into 2 is 72. Okay. So we can put this 0, 20. So 20 by 1. 20 by 1 means 20 is to 1. Okay. 20 is to 1 is the lowest reducible ratio of 30 days to 36 hours. Okay, understood all of you? Listen to the question. In a computer lab, there are 3 computers for every 6 students. How many computers will be needed for 24 students? We have also learned a method for areal cast known as unitary method, in which we first find the value of one unit and then the value of the required number of units. This is a unitary method model. So this question also unitary method. In a computer lab, there are 3 computers for every 6 students. So we can write as for 6 students, number of computer, number of computer in lab equal how many computers? 3 computers for every 6 students. So for 6 students, number of computers in lab equal 3. Therefore this is the therefore symbol. Therefore for one student number of computer in lab equal, yes, 1 student 3 by 6. Okay. Then how many computers will be needed for 24 students? So next we want to find out for 24 students. For 24 students, Number of computer needed equal to. See, 1 student 3 by 6. So 24 students, yes, 3 by 6 into 24. We can cancel 6 and 24. Yes, how many times? 4, 6 are 24. Then multiply 3 into 4. 3 into 4 is 12. So 12 computers are needed for 24 students. Okay. Question. Population of Rajasthan 570 lakhs and population of UP 1660 lakhs. Area of Rajasthan 3 lakh kilometer square and area of UP 2 lakh kilometer square. How many people are there per kilometer square in both these states? Which state is less populated? So we want to find out the number of people in Rajasthan and number of people in UP. So the Rajasthan state the population of Rajasthan given as population of Rajasthan population of Rajasthan equal 570 lakh. Okay. Then given the area of Rajasthan 3 lakh. Area of Rajasthan equal to 3 lakh per kilometer. kilometer square. Okay, 3 lakh kilometer square. So, number of people in per kilometer square equal to, how can we find out? The population of Rajasthan is 570. Area of the Rajasthan equal to 3 lakh kilometer square. So, the number of people in per kilometer square is equal to population of Rajasthan divided by area of the Rajasthan. Okay. So, we can cancel by 3 and 570. 1, 3 is 3. 2 balance 27, 9 threes are 27, then this 0. So, the number of people equal to 190. Okay. Then, again how many people in there per kilometer in both states. So, we want to find out Uttar Pradesh, UP also. So, UP is equal to, given population of UP equal to, population of UP is equal to 1660 lakh. Okay. Then area of UP equal to 2 lakh kilometer square. Then find out the number of people in UP. Yes, population of UP divided by area of UP. Cancellation 8 2s are 16, this 3 2s are 6, then this 0. Okay, otherwise you can divide 1660 divided by 2. So the answer is the number of people is 830. Then this is the first question answer. Then second question, listen, which state is less populated? So less populated means the number of people less. Comparing these two states, Rajasthan 190, UP 830. Which is less? Yes, 190. That means a Rajasthan state. So Rajasthan is less populated. Okay, Rajasthan is less populated. Okay,
person is derived from the Latin word percentum. Percentum is mean the two words, per and centum. The meaning of cent is 100. Person literally means per 100 or every 100. Person is denoted by the sign. The concept person can be explained using the example of air composition. Look carefully, air is made up of many gases. The systematic use all gases if combined together form 100 parts. If the total air composition is 100, then 78 part of 100 part or 78% of the total air composition is formed nitrogen. Similarly, 21 part out of 100 or 21% is air composition oxygen, and the remaining 1 part out of 100 parts or 1% consists other gases. As you can show, percentage is the numerator of a fraction whose denominator is 100.
Listen to the exercise 8.2 question. Convert the given fractional numbers to percent. Percent means percentage. So here given the first fractional number is 1 by 8. This 1 by 8 change into percentage multiplied by, we know the percentage equal 100. 100%. So multiply by 100%. Okay. We know this is in multiplication in numerator case. 1 into 100 we can write as 100 by, yes, 8%. 100 by 8 we can divide by 4, we can cancel by 4, we get by 4 we get 2 fours are 8, 25 fours are 100. So we can write as that's equal to 25/2%. 25/2%. Okay. Then we know this is the numerator is greater than the denominator in proper fraction. So we can convert into mixed fraction. 25/2 is 1 2 is 2, 5 balance, 2 2 are 4, remaining 1. So we can write as quotient 12 into 12 and remainder 1/2%. 12 and 1/2%. Okay. The next question is 3/4. So 3/4 fractional number change into percentage multiply by 100%. Okay. We can cancel 4 and 100. How many times? 4 in 100? Yes, 25. 25 into 4 equal to 100. Then we can multiply 3 into 25. 3 into 25 is? Yes, 75%. 25 into 3 is equal 75. Okay. Then listen this question. Last question. Rational number is given as 3/40. 3/40 change into percentage. Yes, multiply by 100%. We can cancel this 0 and 0. Okay. Then 4 and 10 into 2 2s are 4, 5 2s are 10. Then listen, this numerator only 2 numbers, 3 into 5. Yes, 3 into 5 15, by denominator this 2 only, 2, 15/2%. This is the fractional. This is in proper fraction. We can change into 15/2. 7 2s are 14. A remainder 1. So we can write as quotient and remainder by divisor. 7 and 1/2%. Okay. Then convert the decimal fraction to percentage. Given the decimal number, first number is 0.65 to change into percentage. Yes, any number change into percentage multiply by 100%. Okay, so 0.65 change into percentage multiply by 100%. We know we can convert this decimal number into fraction after the decimal 2 number. So we can write this as a fraction 65/100. Okay. Into 100%. We can cancel this 100 and 100. Numerator and denominator 100 is here. Cancel. We get the answer equal to 65%. Okay. Then 2.1%. 2.1 we can write as 2.1 into 100%. 2.1 we can write as in the fraction form. Yes, after the 0.1 number, so 21/10 into 100%. Okay. Then we can cancel 10 and 100. 10 tens are 100, so 10. Then multiply this numerator 21 into 10. Yes, 210%. Right, do put this symbol, percentage symbol, 210%. Then see this last decimal number 0.02. So 0.02 change into percentage multiplied by 100%. Then 0.02 after the 0.2 number, so change into fraction by 100. Okay, 2 by 100 into 100%. We can cancel this 100. So we get 2 into percentage, 2%. Okay, so any fractional number or any decimal number, any number change into percentage multiply by 100%. Okay, next question, find 50% of 250. So 50% we can write as 50 by 100. Okay, of into 250. Okay, 50%. This is equal to 50% of 250. We can cancel by this 0, 0. Then 10, 9, 25. Is possible 5 divided by 5. 2 5s are 10 and yes, 5 5s are 25. Okay, then cancellation is not possible. So 15 into 5. 15 into 5 is, yes, 75. So 75 by the denominator is 2. Okay, 75 by 2. So 75 by 2 we can change into, this is the numerator is greater than the denominator in proper fraction. We can change into mixed fraction or decimal. So 75 divided by 2. Is equal 3 2s are 6, 1 balance, then 5, 7 2s are 14, 1 balance. So we can this write as 37 and 1 by 2. Okay, 37 and 1 by 2 or 75 by 2. Okay, so the 50% of 2. 15% of 250 is 75 by 2 or 37 and 1 by 2. Then 1% of 1 hour. 1% of 1 hour we can write as 1%. 1% equal 1 by 100 into 1 hour. Okay. So 1 into 1 is 1 by 100. Yes, 1 by 100. 1% of 1 hour is 1 by 100. We can change into this as in decimal. 1 by how many zeros here? 2 zeros. So change into 2 plus 0.01. Yes, hour. Okay, 0.01 hour. Then the third question C is 75% of 1 kilogram. 75% of, you know, 1 kilogram equal to, yes, 1000 gram. Okay, so 75% is 75 by 100. 75 by 100 into 1 kilogram. 1 kilogram is 1000 gram. Okay, we can cancel this 0, this 0, 2 zeros. Okay, then 75 into 10, 750. Yes, this is in here kilogram change into gram. So here answer is 750 gram. Okay, then listen this question. Find the all quantity if 5% of, if it is, sorry, 5% of it is 600. So 5% of it is 600 means that all quantity of all quantity, 5% of all quantity is 600. Okay, so we can write as 5% of, 5% we can write as, yes, 5 by 100 of is into, of it is means this all quantity. So 5% of all quantity equal, okay, all quantity equal how much? 600. So 5% of all quantity equals to 600, we want to find out the all quantity. So all quantity equal, here is 600 is here, then this fraction 5/100 into here division, take the reciprocal, we get 100 by denominator, change into this numerator. Okay, division here, multiplication, multiplication, division by 5, 100 by 5. So we can cancel 5 and 600, we can or 5 and 100 we can cancel. 2 5s are 10, then this 0. Okay, here 1. Then we can write as 600 into 20. 600 into 20. See, 6 into 2 is 12. Then put how many zeros? Here 2 0 and 1 0, 3 0. Okay, so the all quantity equal to 12,000. Okay, so the 5% of 12,000 equal 600. Okay, then listen, 40% of it is 500 kilometer. So 40% of it is 500 kilometer. We can write as 40% of means into the all quantity. Okay, all quantity equal 500 kilometer. So 40% we can write as, yes, 40/100. Okay, into all quantity equal to 500. So the all quantity equal to 500. Here multiplication, division, so fraction, take the reciprocal, so 100 by 40. We can cancel by, we can cancel first zero, this zero and this zero, then 4 and 100, 400, 25 4 is 100. Okay, then find out the whole quantity, 50 into 25. What is 50 into 25? Find out 50 into 25. We can find 50 into 25. 0, 0. 5 5s are 25, 2 balance. 5 2s are 10. Plus 2, 12. So we get 1250. Okay, so here 1250. So all quantity is equal 1250. Okay, understood? Okay. In a city, 30% are females, 40% are males, and the remaining are children. What percent children? So given percentage of female. So percentage of female equal 30%. Then given percentage of male equal 40%. Then we want to find out the percentage of children. The remaining are children. So percentage of children equal to, how can we find out the percentage of children? We know percentage means 100. So out of 100, 30% are females and 40% are male. So we can find out the remaining percentage of children are 100 minus, yes, percentage of female plus percentage of male. Okay, so we get 100 minus percentage. So 100 minus 70, 30 plus 40, 70%. So we get the answer equal to 100 minus 70 is, yes, 30%. So 30% are children. Okay, then adding this percentage, 30% female, then 40% male, Then again 30% children. So we get how much total? Yes, 100. Okay. Then next question. Out of 15,000 otters in a constituency, 60% otter. Find the percentage of otters who did not ought. Can you now find how many actually did not ought? So we know 60% otter means if there were 100 otters, out of them 60 otters and the remaining did not ought. Okay, 60% otter means out of 100 otters. Okay, means if there were 100 otters, out of them 60 otter. Okay, 60 otter. The remaining is did not ought. So we want to find out otters who did not ought. So otters who did not ought equal to, here given one, total otters out of 15,000 otters given. So out of 100 otters, we can find out out of 100 otters, 100 otters, here 60 otter, so who did not ought, otters did not ought equal to 100 minus 60, 60 are otter, so otters did not ought equal to 100 minus 60, how many? Yes, 40%. Okay, 40% are did not ought. So the actual number of out of 100 otters, 40 did not. Okay, 40 did not ought. Then, so out of how many? 15,000. 15,000 otters who did not ought, who did not ought equal to 40% of 15,000. Okay, so 40% means 40 by 100 of into 15,000. So by cancellation, cancel this 20, then multiply 40 into 15. Yes, 4 into 15 is 60. Then put this 20. So we get 4 into 15, 60. Then this 0, these 20. Yes, 6,000. So 6,000 otters are did not ought. The number of otters did not ought. Okay. So actually did not ought, we can find out the same method, 40% of, can you now find out how many actually did not ought? Same method, the actual number of voters who did not ought equal to 40% of 15,000, 40 by 100 into 15,000, we get the same answer, 6,000. Okay. Okay, listen this question. Meera save rupees 4000 from her salary. If this is 10% of her salary, what is her salary? So Meera saves rupees 400. Okay, Meera save rupees 400 from her salary. If this is 10% of her salary, what is her salary? So we don't know how much is her salary. So we take as let salary of Meera, we can take one unquantity, that any one variable. So take us, let the salary of Meera be, let's P rupees, okay, P rupees. Then saving from her salary is 10% of, 10% of salary is 400. So saving from her salary is 10% of full salary, rupees P. Okay. So 10% of P equal, saving is given 400. So 10% means 10/100 of into full salary P equal to 400. So full salary P equal to 400 is here. Then take this fraction into here, division. So division fraction is multiply its reciprocal. So we get 100 is in numerator place and 10 is in denominator. Okay. 100 multiply 10 is in division. Then we can use the cancellation. 10 and 100, how many times? 10 tens are 100. So we get the total rupees equal to her salary, full salary is equal to 4000 rupees. Okay, 4000 is her salary. So salary of Meera is rupees. Salary of Meera is, Meera is a rupees 4000. Okay. Then next question. A cricket team played 20 matches in one season. In 125% of them, how many matches did they win? So 20 matches in one season, it won 25% of them. That means out of 100 matches, percentage means out of 100. So out of 100 matches, number of matches they win, number of matches won equal to 25%. So out of 100 matches, number of matches won 25. So out of 20 matches in one season, how many matches did one? So out of 20 matches, number of matches won equal to 25% of 20. So 25/100 into 20. We can cancel 25 and 100. 25 1 times, 100 in 4 times. Okay, 125 is 25, 4 25 is 100. Then 4 and 25. So answer is equal 5 matches. So sum, number of matches won by team is, number of matches won by team equal 5 matches. Okay, understood all of you? Okay, listen. Divide 15 sweets between Manu and Sonu so that they get 20% and 80% of them respectively. So the number of sweets Manu gets equal 20% of 15, and number of sweets Sonu gets 80% of 50. Therefore, the sweets Manu gets equal Manu and Sonu, so that they get 20%. So 20% is Manu. So 20% of 50. So 20% 20/100 into 15. We can cancel this 0 and 0. 10 and 2. 2 we can cancel. 2 and 10. 2 in 1 times. 10 is in. Yes. 5 times. 5 and 15. Yes. We get 3. Okay. So 3 sweets got Manu. Okay. Then the sweets Sonu gets. The sweets Sonu gets equal to 80% of 50. So we get 80/100 into 50. Cancel the zeros. Cancel 0, 0. And 10 and 15. 2 5s are 10. 3 5s are 15. And 2 and 8 is how many times? 4 2s are 8. Then multiply 4 into 3. 4 into 3 is 12. 12 number of sweets get Sonu and 3 number of sweets gets Manu. Adding these two sum, 3 plus 12. How many sweets? 15 sweets. Okay. Then listen. Next question. If angle of a triangle are in the ratio 2 is to 3 is to 4, find the values of each angle. So these are in a ratio 2 is to 3 is to 4. We know a triangle has 3 angles. Given the ratio, not an actual measure, that is in a ratio 2 is to 3 is to 4. Okay. So, we multiply one constant. These two, this 2 is to 3 is to 4 is the ratio. So, we multiply one constant is we get the actual measures. 2x is to 3x is to 4x. Okay. So, we can write as the actual angles be the ratio of the angle equal to 2 is to 3 is to 4. So, the actual angles of the angle equal to 2x is to 3x is to 4x. Then we know sum of 3 angles of a triangle is, yes, 180 degree. Okay. 3 angles, sum of 3 angles of a triangle equal to 180 degree. So, adding these measures, 2x plus 3x plus 4x equal to 180 degree. So, 2x plus 3x, 5x plus 4x, 9x equal to 180 degree, x equal to 180/9, we get answer equal to, yes, cancel. 9 and 180 in 2 times, then put this 0, x equal to 20. Okay, so, the this is the x that fixed constant value. So, the actual measures are 2x. 2x, hence the angles are, hence the angles are 2x. 2x, 2 into x is 20, 40 degree. Then, the second angle is 3x equal 3 into 20, 60 degree. And the fourth angle is 4x equal 4 into 20, 80 degree. Okay. So, the angles are 40, 60, 80. Adding these measures, 40 plus 60 plus 80, we get 180, the total sum of the three angles of a triangle, 180 degree. Here given the ratio 2:3:4. So the actual angles are 40 degree, 60 degree and 80 degree. Okay, understood all of you?
Okay, listen this question. A chalk contains calcium, carbon and oxygen 10:3:12. Find the percentage of carbon in chalk. So given the ratios, given ratio is equal to 10:3:12. Okay, that is in chalk contains the calcium, carbon and oxygen. So total parts we can find out the total parts contained in chalk. Total parts equal to, we can add this ratio 10:3:12. We get the total ratio equal to 25. 10 plus 3 is 13. 13 plus 12 is 25. Then we want to find out the carbon, percentage of carbon in chalk. So percentage of carbon in chalk is, listen, this is calcium, this is carbon, this is in oxygen. Okay, so carbon ratio is here 3. So find out the percentage of carbon in chalk equal to percentage of carbon in chalk equal to parts by which carbon is present in chalk is, carbon is second given, carbon, so is in 3. So parts by which carbon is present in chalk, divided by total parts, total containing these carbon, calcium and oxygen, total parts into 100%. Okay, equal to parts by which carbon present is 3 by total part is 25 into 100%. So we can cancel this 25 and 100. Yes, 4 times 4 into 3, 12%. Okay, 12% carbon contained in chalk. So answer is equal to 12%. Okay, next question is, if in a stick of chalk carbon is 3 gram, what is the weight of the chalk stick? Means percentage of weight of the chalk stick. So here given the same ratio. So the ratios equal to 10:3:12. So that is in carbon, calcium, carbon and oxygen. So we know the total parts, we find out the sum of the ratio is equal to, that is a total total sum of the ratio. So the sum of ratio is equal to 10:3:12, that is equal to 25 gram. So that means 25 gram. Okay, then you want to find out the weight of the chalk stick, percentage. So percentage of weight of which item? Carbon. Carbon is 3 gram. Okay, so percentage of weight carbon is chalk stick equal, carbon is chalk stick equal to weight of carbon or in stick by chalk stick by total
weight of chopstick into 100%. So here given the weight of the carbon is 3 gram by total weight of the stick is 25 into 100%. So we can cancel by 25 and 100 is 4. 3 into 4 we get, yes, 12%. So the weight of the carbon in chopstick is 12%. Here 12% of carbon is present in the chop. Here the weight also, weight of carbon in chalk equal to 12%. Okay.